Hi, I'm Jessica Gardner.
And I'm Lenna Castro.
And you are watching This Week in Mount Athletics. Once again, I'm junior Jessica Gardner.
And I'm freshman Lenna Castro, and we are both members of the Mount St. Mary's swim team and your hosts for this week.
We would like to welcome everyone to the 18th edition of This Week in Mount Athletics, presented by the Carriage House.
Hey Jess, remember this weekend when it was really warm outside?
Hardly. It is so cold now. It's like subarctic.
Yeah, it's freezing. I hate walking out in the cold now.
Well, I hate to break up this conversation, but we need to get to the highlights.
Very clever, Jess. This week, the women's basketball team traveled way up north to face off for two conference games. Let's check it out.
The women's basketball team started off the weekend strong with a comeback overtime win over Bryant 86-84. Senior guard Selena Mann scored the decisive basket to give them the win and added 7 assists. Junior guard Sydney Henderson scored a team-high 21 points. They then traveled to Central Connecticut State and had another late rally to force the game into overtime. This time, however, the Mount could not hold on as they lost 77-73. 4 players scored in double figures, including Henderson with 18, Mann with 15, junior forward Rachel Matthews with a career-high 13 points, and sophomore guard Jacqueline Brewer with 11.
The men's basketball team made the same trip playing both Bryant and Central Connecticut State. Let's head back up north.
The weekend started with a heartbreaking 79-78 overtime loss to Bryant, the number one team in the NEC. Freshman guard Siobhan Wiggins scored a career-high 20 points, while junior guards Rashad Wack and Sam Prescott combined for 33 points. The men finished the weekend strong, however, defeated Central Connecticut State 80-75. 5 players scored in double digits. Leading the way for the Mountaineers were sophomore forward Xavier Owens and junior guard Julian Norfleet with 18 points. Last but not least, the track team traveled to Bucknell for the Bucknell Golden Invitational. Let's go!
The track team had a very strong showing at the Bucknell Golden Invitational as freshman Gina Marie McCant won the 500-meter dash and qualified for the ECACs, while on the men's side, the 4x800-meter relay team consisting of grad student Gigi Gibalesco, sophomore Tommy Grishow, senior Chris Wisco, and freshman Cody Wilson won and qualified for the IC4As. Senior John Fernandez had a school record toss in the weight throw and finished third overall. The women's 4x800-meter relay was also victorious at the meet.
And now it's time to announce this week's Athlete of the Week.
Congratulations to senior Chris Swisco. Swisco accomplished the IC4A hat trick as he has qualified for IC4As in 3 events in 3 straight weeks. So congrats to him and his successful season thus far. The women will also be making the trip to Robert Morris on Saturday to face off against their in-conference rivals, but then will come back home after a 5-game road trip to face Wagner. Here is a member of the Mount women's basketball team inviting you to the game.
Hey Mount fans, this is Jody Shiggy from Women's Mount Basketball. We play Wagner Monday, 7 p.m. Be there. Just came back from a 5-game road trip, and it's really nice to be home and back on campus. It'd be even nicer if you guys came to support us. We play 7 p.m. Monday, and hope to see you there. Go Mount!
The track team will be heading to the Penn State National Invitational this Saturday and Sunday, so good luck to them.
Finally, we'll be heading to Catholic this weekend.
Right, and then we'll come back home to square off against Loyola the following weekend for our final home meet of the season and the final meet before NECs.
Our season so far has been going really well, and we've been practicing really hard, and we've all been improving a lot.
Yeah, I think we've been doing a really good job. Everybody's working a lot harder than we were last year. You know, we're really pulling forward, and hopefully, you know, we just keep getting better.
Remember that you can get all your Mount Athletics news at mountathletics.com and check us out on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, and Instagram by searching for Mount Athletics. You can also like us on Facebook by texting Like Mount Athletics to 32665.
Don't forget the next time you are at the Knott Arena to enter our Twit Pick of the Day contest. All you have to do is take a picture of the action and tweet it at Mount Athletics, and if your picture is chosen as the pick of the day, you could win a cool Mount Athletics prize. Don't delay and show your Mount pride today.
And remember that there is a chance to win a cool Mount Athletics prize in every This Week in Mount Athletics episode presented by the Carriage House.
Also, don't forget that the Mount is celebrating the 40th anniversary of the first year women were admitted at the Mount.
That's right. For the next 5 weeks, Mount Athletics will be honoring 40 women for their outstanding careers at the Mount.
Mount Athletics will be unveiling several videos about these outstanding females on the list. It will culminate with a celebration on February 16th during the basketball doubleheader against Central Connecticut State.
For more information, check out and like the Facebook page called Mount St. Mary's Women in Sports.
Once again, I'm Jessica Gardner.
And I'm Lenna Castro.
And this was This Week in Mount Athletics.